Thanks for joining us. I'm Marlon Bowling, your tour guide to the Ag Commodities. Happy Friday to you. Well, glad to have you with us. And we have some new export sales activity to talk about overnight. Didn't have anything for like about a week or more. And then now we've had a couple back-to-back days. Yesterday, we had a fairly large sale of corn to China. This morning, what we have is a sale of soybeans to China. It was two boatloads, 132,000 tons that were sold to China. And it looks like it is all old crop. So that means, hey, they'll take it right away. Isn't that interesting? Here to talk about it, let's bring in Brian Hoops of Midwest Market Solutions. He's in Springfield, Missouri. So it looks like maybe they have their buying shoes back on here after kind of an absence for a little while. Do you read much into this activity or not?
Good morning, Marlon. Well, you know, there's been some rumors yesterday that they were back in the market for U.S. soybeans. It looks like China, you know, it's on lockdown, but they're starting to be prepared to come back out of that lockdown. And that would mean some more buying interest for corn, as we noted yesterday, soybeans, as we noted this morning. So they are starting to kind of get back to normal, even though the country's still, most of it's locked down anyway. So it's a bullish number. We saw USDA yesterday raise their export forecast for old crop soybeans by 25 million bushels. You know, it still looks like they may need to raise it again in the June supply and demand report, because we're easily meeting the pace we need to hit that USDA forecast, even with the small revision higher yesterday. So it should be, you know, a little supportive for the market after such a big drop in values over the last month or so.
Okay, let's take a look at the overnight trade here and what the market did the morning after the USDA reports. So here we go with July corn, just 0.75 cents higher at 792 1/4. Some may be thrown off a little bit by that nearby May contract. It was up over 11 cents overnight. But really, there is no trade going on in that one, right? That's in delivery.
Yeah, absolutely. Last trading date is today for the May contract. So you pretty much just throw them away. Nobody that, you know, that's watching us is going to be trading in that contract. So you, most of the trade is focused on somewhat on the July, but a lot of producers focused on that December contract. It's a very attractive price. We've heard from producers talking about, you know, it's $7 out of the field or even better with a tight basis. But we want to just really encourage your listeners and watchers of this program. If you are making cash sales, you really have to look at re-ownership strategies. You know, this year is going to be go down as a late planted crop. Comparable season probably was 2019. We're looking for a little over 40% of the crop to be seeded by Monday, 43, maybe 45% in 2019. 38% of the crop was seeded. So, you know, that was a kind of a comparable year. And that year, not only did we lose some acres to be seeded, we also lost yield. It was down considerably from trend. And you know, so if history is our guide, we are looking at reduced corn acres in the June acreage report. And we're going to look at further yield reductions from the USDA. Yesterday's number was kind of a surprising drop, just from the standpoint they haven't lowered the yield numbers since 2013 in the May supply demand report, but it's certainly warranted, but it's still at contract highs. You know, it's the largest crop we'd ever raise at 177 bushels per acre. So it's really subject to revisions going forward.
Well, December corn was a penny higher in the overnight trade. Let's check out our soybean market. Our quotes are from bar chart. And in July, we were 9 3/4 cents higher overnight at 1623 1/2. November was up 5 1/2 cents. And then, of course, yesterday, all the fireworks was in the wheat after the reports came out. Well, they backed up a little bit overnight. July Chicago wheat down 6 3/4 cents. Meanwhile, in that Kansas City market, July down 2 1/2 cents at 1267 1/2. Keep in mind, the Wheat Quality Council's wheat tour gets underway next week out in Kansas and surrounding areas. Spring wheat trade overnight higher, 7 1/4 higher on July at 1323 1/4. We'll come back and talk a little bit about our livestock trade with Brian Hoops when we come back. Well, thanks for joining us today. And I'm Marlon Bowling, joined by Brian Hoops of Midwest Market Solutions. Well, as we review our trade from yesterday on the livestock market, I want to discuss with you what is going to be impacting here this livestock trade. Let's go to live cattle closes from yesterday. And on the board, we had a lot of pressure. We had the June down $1.92. August was down $1.87. Look at October yesterday. For some reason, it was down $2.07. They really picked on that one. On the feeder cattle market yesterday afternoon, when we hit the close, August was down $3.47. And gosh, August, September, and October, all roughly $3.50 lower. They really hit the skids yesterday. And then on the lean hog trade, as we got to the end of the trading session, June was down $3.37 and $97.47. July was down $3.70. Brian, it was an ugly day in that livestock trade yesterday. And it was kind of odd because on the flip side of the coin, you look at the grain side and about the only big mover was wheat. So what the heck was weighing on all the livestock trade?
Well, yeah, you know, the December corn, new crop corn, was up pretty sharply yesterday, about 15, 16 cents, I think. And so that certainly had an impact on what happened with the feeder cattle and just seemed to spill over into live cattle. The hog market's just in a straight free fall right now. You know, that's market that's really technically driven, and the trend has turned lower. Each day that we make new lows, you find new selling underneath the previous day's lows. And so that market kind of just building on itself from the standpoint that it's a snowball going down the hill. The faster it goes, the more snow it's picking up, and the more aggressive the selling is. You know, the cattle market may get a little bit of a reprieve or a bounce here because cutout values were higher. You know, slaughter pace remains really strong, so there's still strong demand for the cattle, and our steer weights were down yesterday, so there's a lot of positive fundamentals. But you know, with the corn market moving higher, pressuring feeder cattle, it's hard with the cattle market struggling and the funds willing sellers. And I think you will find willing sellers on the cattle market on any substantial rallies as the economy continues to struggle and there's concerns about the consumer demand for beef and for pork for that matter.
Well, they always say never catch a falling knife, and that kind of applies here in this case. But on the other hand, is that knife getting pretty close to the floor?
You never know. You know, it's I've heard that saying before, and it is very true. You've got to be careful, especially in the hog market, because that market will go a lot farther than what you can expect it will. And you know, I think it's showing traders exactly that, going from, you know, the upper 120s now just to free falling into below $100. So it may not be done yet, even though it does look like it's extremely oversold.
And not to pile on here for producers, but just wanted to point out, overnight, West Texas Intermediate crude oil on the June futures, yeah, it was $3.04 higher this morning. Now $3.07 higher at $109.20 per barrel, so heading up there toward $110 again. Yikes. Okay, Brian, thank you so much for the comments this morning. You have a good weekend. Brian Hoops, Midwest Market Solutions. So, Janet, that's the setup for today's trade. Here we go.